Welcome to the Advanced Geekery Project Lab, where I'm testing 3D printers for your entertainment and edification. Today we'll be looking at the Kobra 2, a new printer from Anycubic. My name is David Gewurz, and you're watching the Advanced Geekery channel. In addition to testing 3D printers, I also explore maker and smart home technology, stress test servers, fly drones, and regularly dive deep into advanced geekery for fun and profit. Here's how this review is going to work. Most 3D printers have a lot to like, but they also include their fair share of head scratchers and genuine annoyances. As I go through the review, I'll be giving everything I like a good, everything that's just plain odd a rating of weird, and everything I don't like a point for ugly. Think of weird as a measure of what were they thinking, and ugly as a measure of, that's bad. Let's get started. A commonly accepted product marketing aphorism is fast, cheap, or good, pick two. With the Anycubic Kobra, however, you get all three. The printer is astonishingly fast, fairly inexpensive compared to others in its speed class, and produces surprisingly clean prints. The Kobra is an FDM, fused deposition modeling 3D printer, which means it uses melted extruded filament to build objects layer by layer. Anycubic is somewhat better known for its resin printers, but the company makes a fine line of FDM printers as well. Setup for the Kobra 2 was relatively straightforward. It comes in a few pieces that you have to screw together. The only thing I really don't like is how you have to balance the gantry and the base together to get those bottom screws to go in straight. It's a common problem across most bed slingers. Common or not, the slightly risky, vaguely stressful assembly process earns the Kobra its first ugly. Any bed slinger where you have to balance delicate components in an awkward position will earn an ugly from me for assembly. At 250 by 220 by 220, the build area is slightly smaller than the Anycubic Viper I reviewed last year. The Kobra 2 printer uses a heated extruder to melt the filament and deposit layers on the build plate. It's at the extruder that we start to see some features that help the Kobra 2 print so quickly. The extruder is direct drive, which means it pulls the filament directly into the hot end. This provides the printer more control over filament movement compared to printers that have the gearing mechanism some distance away from the extruder. That earns the Kobra 2 its first good. Faster printers tend to use a remote push mechanism because it makes the gantry lighter and therefore less subject to forces of inertia. But the Kobra 2 uses robust metal wheels to counter those forces while supporting the entire extruder mechanism. Plus, they won't wear out after heavy use. Here, the Kobra racks up another good. It also uses dual lead screws, which move the gantry up and down evenly. It is interesting that the two lead screws are coordinated by a rubber belt rather than another metal part. Even so, it works. The dual metal lead screws score the Kobra 2 another good, but the rubber belt in combination with all the other metal parts earns it its first weird. The printer also has a flexible steel magnetic plate with a coating that works fairly well for bed adhesion. I had some problems with bed adhesion, but when I cranked up the bed temperature a bit and added some glue stick, prints stayed on the plate like they're supposed to. I'll give the flexible steel plate a good, and the occasional bed adhesion challenges another ugly. Don't take that ugly too seriously, though, because it's fixable with more bed heat and a bit of glue. It's an easy fix, but other flexible beds do hold better. There's no Wi-Fi camera, but few bed slingers have those features. What the printer does have is a micro SD slot and a USB-C connector. That opens the door to OctoPrint control and easy management. So in concert with its touch panel display, the Kobra 2 earns another good. Without any special tuning, the Kobra 2 was roughly 30 to 45% faster than the other printers. Now, Anycubic claims a 5x speed improvement, which I did not see. Such speeds may be possible with a lot of tuning or by benchmarking against poorly configured comparison printers. Even so, a speed increase of 30 to 45% right out of the box and running the default configuration is impressive and can lead to some considerable time savings. No doubt about it, that's a good. The printer earns its next good because of price. It's $279 on Amazon. Make sure you apply the coupon if available. Also check the Anycubic site because sometimes their pricing direct is less expensive. But keep in mind shipping and those sorts of issues. The printer is under $300 and also includes a filament runout sensor, a power fail resume feature, and automatic bed leveling. It's equipped with features that together are normally found only on much more expensive devices. So I'm going to give it a good, good, good one for each feature. And with that, let's move on to some actual printing. I started off with the basic Benchy. It printed quite well. You can see some issues with slight layer offset and some blobbing and stringing in the final print. Top surface quality was good. Next, I printed my standard Yoda test print. I always look at the chin and ears to see how the printer does with overhangs and no supports. Print quality in here was good, with just a tiny bit of drooping and dribbling. Then I moved on to the Adelinde Dragon. This is an extremely difficult model to print support-free, which is why I've started using it to test. In general, the Dragon print came out just fine. There's one spot on the wing where there's some distortion, but it's only on one wing and can be fairly easily sanded out. Even so, it's a literal ding in the print quality. Finally, I printed the Dice Tower. This print came out great and didn't show the artifacting that was slightly visible on the Dragon and the Benchy. Overall, this turned out to be a very nice print, and it showcases what the printer is capable of. So do I recommend you buy this? I bottom line this printer to you at the beginning of this video. Fast, cheap, or good, pick two. But with the Anycubic Kobra 2, you get all three. It's an excellent printer, especially given its price and speed. Unless I discover something in ongoing use, the Kobra 2 is going to be my standard recommendation for an entry-level yet powerful printer. For under $300, I have yet to see anything that comes close. What do you think? Is this a printer you'd like to use? Let us know in the comments below. My name is David Gewurz. Go out there and make it awesome.